He was my Bible study teacher. Amen. He was my mentor. And for many years, we lose contact somehow. And then we got connected again. And ever since, when I need to speak to somebody, he's somebody I speak to. Amen. So many of you want to wonder who Reverend Wambolo's consorts, you know, who you rub your heart with is the man. Amen. It's Reverend Dr. William Osagede. Hallelujah. Shall we International Christian Ministries? Amen. He has a lot of responsibility. He oversees a lot of churches in many countries of the world. Australia, Malta, East Africa, Philippines, Fiji, and Nepal. And he's always traveling with the word of God. Amen. He's married, hallelujah, with wonderful children. Amen. They are not here today. And Belinda is here with him. Amen. Praise God. And I want to say that I want you to open your heart. He's the man that preached the gospel. If you were here on Friday, he believed so much in the undiluted word of God. And that is why he has a lot of engagement, but he chose to, spend this time with us. I believe he's just coming from one. Hallelujah. And please join me as we welcome Reverend Dr. William Osagede. God bless you. Welcome to SGMI. And just flow as the Lord leads you. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Those of you who know me, I'm always loud, yeah? It's in the house of the Lord, we are not shy. Amen.
Amen.
When we come to church, we make noise, we dance, we rejoice. We hear the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So lift and say, Father.
Father.
Speak to my heart.
Speak to my heart.
Touch my life.
Touch my life.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
We are bringing greetings from our church in Australia and from my wonderful wife, Pastor Claire, and our two boys, Zachariah and Caleb. They are home right now. They are about to go to bed because the time changed. But God bless them for sending me here and praying with us to come. And all our church, our brothers and sisters who are praying for us. I'm so glad to be in the church here today of our wonderful Reverend Ewambo, a man that I've loved so much from the very beginning. Man, you can tell that God has lifted this man. Hallelujah. Amen. And I'm happy to meet your family. Amen. We're going to continue where we stopped last Friday. Arise, he is coming. We said the Lord of voices call people today. The voice of suffering call people. The voice of depression. The voice of oppression. The voice of pain. They are calling people everywhere. And you find that people respond accordingly to these voices. Today, the voice of death also call people. People can no longer stay alive because they feel that their life is finished. And so many people are tired of life, but they look around and they say, what do I do now? But here comes a voice that I want you to listen to tonight. Amen. The Bible tells me in the book of Mark chapter 10, I wrote only one verse 49. And Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. And they called the blind man and said unto him, be of good comfort. Arise, he is calling you. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Of death or oppression or depression or pain, but a voice of hope, a voice of joy, a voice of deliverance, a voice of grace, he's calling you. So because of that, you cannot stay quiet, you're going to arrive because he's calling you.
Amen.
I love you when God tells us, be of good comfort, be of good cheer. Because you know what, friend, the world we live in, there's a lot of people who have brought pain to us. We woke up in the morning and unexpectedly, pain comes to us. From people we trust, our friends, our in-laws, our neighbors. Sometimes we cry on the inside and we can't express it out. Sometimes we have pain on the inside and nobody knows what we're going through really. Because on the outside we are very good in putting up a mask. We show the world that everything is okay, but we are dying on the inside. And so many people come to church, and because of it, they pretend to lift up their hands. They pretend to rise up, but because of the pain Because you know what, friends? When Jesus calls you, he calls you to a better life. He calls you to something that you can enjoy him. You know, a man may have all the money, all the wealth, all the influence, all the world. A man may have everything in life. But when a man does not have the Lord Jesus Christ, when a man does not have the power, when a man does not have the assurance, when a man does not have the confidence, when a man does not walk with God, that man is zero. I say it over and over again. Jesus said, unless you be born again. But I'm going to say right now, unless you have a relationship with Jesus Christ, unless you know him, unless you walk with him, unless he's in your heart, when he calls you, you rise up. When he calls you, oppression, depression, pain have no right over your life, because he called you and you will rise for him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is calling you.
Amen.
You can tell from this story. The blind man had been there for 38 years. He was begging. He is tired of life. He was blind. And you know what, when someone is blind, everything stops. Some people today, Pastor Wambo, they are alive, they are walking, but they are blind. They look at you, but they are blind. You know, they can say something, but they are blind. Because they cannot see what God can see. All they can see is the peripheral. All they can see is the surface. But God sees deeper. God sees greater. Hallelujah. And because of that, this blind man, even though he was blind physically, in his heart of heart, he could understand. In his heart of heart, my brother, God has a word for you today. Hallelujah. I feel something powerful going to come over your life. Hallelujah. In his heart of heart, God has got something upon him. In his heart of heart, the man could see. I cannot see, but I can see. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I cannot see, but I can see. Hallelujah. Even though I am blind, but in my heart, I know that somebody powerful. I know that the King of Kings is passing this way. And the Bible said, they told him, Jesus of Nazareth is passing by your way. He already knew that. And he said, I have only one shot. Even though I am blind, but I'm going to do something. And the Bible said, he cried out, Jesus, Jesus, have mercy on me. You know what, friend? I like that word when the Bible says, have mercy on me. I like that one so much. You know why? Because this man, Son of David, have mercy on me. He was actually hitting a nail. Son of David has got many meanings here. The king, the powerful one, the one, you know, David was a mighty man of Israel, yeah? David's significance here, the deliverer, the one that delivered them from Goliath, have mercy on me. In other words, I believe you are more powerful than David. Hallelujah. I believe you have the power to know and love you. Hallelujah. This man could not keep quiet. This man was shouting. And all of a sudden, he said, hey, be quiet. You know how many people in the church have told you to be quiet? You pray too much. Your Christianity is too much. Why go to that small place? There are only a few people. Why go to that place? There's a big cathedral here. And people have told you many things to be quiet. But you've got to remember this man. He said, they told him that he cried out the more. The more they told him to keep quiet, the more he cried. Hallelujah. Because he knows there's no other way out. He knows this is my chance. I got it right there in my heart. I got to take this chance. I got to wake up to it. I don't know about you, but I believe this is our chance. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I believe we as a church here, this church here, standard of God, yeah, this is our chance to rise up. It's our chance to say, we're not going to allow the power of darkness. We're not going to allow the past. We're not going to allow evil. We're not going to allow our mistake. Hey, somebody say amen. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
The mistakes we made 15 years ago and 20 years ago, somebody is still bringing it out and saying, hey, woman, hey, man, do you remember what you did? You're not going to allow that to keep you from judging out. You're going to allow that to hold you back. You're going to say, Jesus.
Oh,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And you know what, man, I'm wicked. The Bible says, your sins and your I will forget, I will remember no more. Far in the bottom of the ocean, a man who is so jealous of you, who is wicked, will put on the thing they used to swim and dive there to go and find your sins. I'm thinking, hey, you see, I remember. That's man. 50 years ago, you did something wrong. 20 years ago. But today they are still announcing. Why? Because they want to destroy you. They don't forgive like man forgives, yeah? And like God forgives. For them, forgiveness is a monopoly only to them. They commit sin, but it's a monopoly for you, no. For God's sake, this man said, some of them have mercy on me. He cried out. The people said, shut up! He really shut up. My sister, my brother, can I tell you this moment? The time for keeping quiet is over. Amen. The time for hallelujah. The time for allowing the world and the darkness and the evil and the power of darkness to take up is over. Amen. We have to cry out. We have to shout. We have to declare. We have to say, God, have mercy on me. God, I need you more. God, I need you more. God, have mercy on me. This is our time. He said, but Pastor, well, you don't understand my story. You don't know where you're coming from, Pastor. Because many people have pointed fingers at me. Many people have thrown stones at me. Many hate me. Many laugh at me. Many have told me many things. In fact, in my house, I'm not accepted. When I walk in, my wife walks out. When I walk in, my husband walks out. There are so many people in my home. My daughter doesn't love me. My children doesn't love me. I'm an outcast. You may be saying that right now. You may be looking around yourself and saying, you don't understand. Somebody stole my money. Somebody stole my sausage. I don't have a job. You may look at me and say, but Pastor William, I'm finished. But I come to tell you this moment. This man, he said, son of David, have mercy on me. They told him, shut up. He cried out the more. I believe the problem with the church is because we have stopped crying. We have stopped shouting. We have stopped declaring. We have stopped asking God. We have stopped declaring what God wants for us. We have kept quiet too long. We've allowed quietness. Do you know that lions, yeah? Lion is only a temporary temporary. When something comes, they roar. Because the lion is made to be a he roars, you know. When a dog, a chihuahua dog, sees a small fly, he barks. But the church of Jesus Christ, the enemy comes from hell and make a nest in our head and we are quiet. It's time to rise up. It's time to say, I'm not going to be quiet anymore. I'm going to shout. Son of the God, I come to realize one thing. If you don't seek it, you don't get it. If you don't seek God to deliver you, you remain as you are. If you don't seek God to move, you remain as you are. And that is why this man said, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Jesus, I need you. Jesus, I need you. I need deliverance. I need healing. I want to walk with you. I am tired of my sin. I'm tired of my Lord. So Jesus, have mercy. Jesus, have mercy. I come before you. I come before you. My brother, my sister, it is time to shout. It is time to cry. It is time to declare that we need him more than before. Hallelujah. And you can do that right now. Amen. You say, Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. I like what Jesus did. The Bible says he stood still and he said, bring him, bring him. Hey, you know what word of God? For God to stand still for a human being, that is something.
Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Jesus stood still. Hallelujah. Amen. And he said to him, hey, man, be of good comfort. He is calling you. Wow! Just imagine that. In other words, my cry has yielded results. Hallelujah! In other words, if I kept quiet, I would be man like this. Can I tell you something, man of God? Your faith in action, your God in motion. Stop allowing the devil to tell you you cannot live holy. Oh, I live in London. Oh, there are too many sins here. Too many prostitutes in Seoul. Too many doubt here. People of God, forget about that. God wants you to shine in the midst of the evil. Yeah. Hallelujah. In the midst of the problem. He wants you to be a child of God in your working place. Everybody is a smoker or a drunkard. Hey, but you shine. Amen. You shine. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So don't tell me it cannot be possible. It is possible. Because this man, he shouted. And Jesus said, call him. He said, he's calling you, man. And the man said, me, who? The Bible said all of a sudden, the man cast away his garment in verse 50. He cast away his garment. And you know what, friend? You know what I mean? He cast away everything that will hinder him. My brother, my sister, you know what, brother? There are things in your life right now that hinders you from responding to the call. Because you know what, friend? When Jesus calls you, and those things try to, you know, somebody told me, he said, Pastor, I had a dream of the rapture. He said, I was going up like this. He said his father came, and his father grabbed one leg. The mother grabbed one leg, and they dragged him down. Hey. I said, no way. I said, my brother, something is wrong. God is telling you something. There are things that you keep in your house that are not godly. You know, friend, can I say this to you? So many people go to church and they put a mask. They appear that they are all okay, but there is something holding them back. That is why they take 1 foot up and 1 foot down. They keep going up and down, up and down. They can never walk with holiness. You can't see the glory of God in their life. You ask yourself, is this what a child of God? Because of their behavior at work. You don't even know if they are a Christian. My brother, can I beg you this morning? It is time for a turn back to God and be a true child of God in the morning, in the afternoon, every hour. Let's walk with God. Hallelujah. Amen. Somebody say it's crazy.
It's crazy.
Hallelujah. This man said, Jesus. And when they called him, he took off his garment and he came to Jesus. I love that. I picture that every day. I picture him coming to Jesus. I picture him saying, here I am, Jesus. He said, he came to Jesus. And the Bible says, Jesus even asked him, what do you want me to do for you? Can you imagine that? Jesus told his blind, yeah? But the man's faith was so powerful. He didn't waste any time. He said, Lord, he didn't start going to story of how his father was angry with him, how his mother did that, how everybody hated. No. He said, one thing, Lord, that I may receive my sight.
Amen.
He didn't make story. He didn't make issue. He didn't make it fight. He said, I want to receive my sight. That's all he wanted. So where are we every day complaining? We wake up, we tell stories that it looks like you are unique. There is no man here that doesn't have problems. So yours is not unique. We all have issues. So why can't you rise up like this man? Instead of going and complaining. I say, all I need is my breakthrough. All I need is my victory. Hallelujah. All I need is my eye to see. All I need is for God to work in my heart. That's all I need. But you see people, they kneel down in their prayer and they begin to argue with God. That wife will give me God. In fact, you see, her hair is already falling. If I brought her teeth, and they begin to argue with God. And they argue. At the end of it all, they forget that they have come for prayer. You get nowhere with that. Because you know what happens is that when you are doing that, you are telling God, God, you made a mistake. Oh. Because you know, God, the woman you gave me, I don't like her anymore. For you to remember that God Almighty doesn't make a mistake. Hallelujah. He gave me a wife for it. Hallelujah. When everything is down, God will lift you up.
Amen.
This man didn't waste time. He said, Jesus, all I want is my sight. That's all I want.
Amen.
So can I ask you this moment? When you hear the voice of Jesus calling you, what do you want? Are you going to start complaining that 20 years ago, your grandfather or your in-law or your brother-in-law or whatever cast you out of the house in London, or because you couldn't pay the rent, they threw you out there? What's the point of that? But now you're not like that. Oh God, you don't understand. Oh God, you see, when I was working in East London, something happened to me. When I was working in Peckham, somebody snagged my back. Is that your story? You can do better than that. Oh, you're going to come before me. God, you know what, God? This me, I want to live my life to glorify you. I want to walk with you, Lord. I want to be your representative in this country. I want to walk so powerful with you. Lord Jesus, I am tired of the sin people are doing. But Lord Jesus, because you died for me, I want to be different. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. I want to be holy. I want to walk with you. And everywhere I go, in my working place, in my house, in my school, in my car, everywhere I go, I want to be more like Jesus. If you can only cry, I'll cry this moment.
Amen.
That's all you need to cry.
Hallelujah.
That's all you need to cry.
Thank you, Jesus.
And this man, Jesus, did something wonderful. Did something wonderful. And the Bible says, Jesus looked at him powerfully. He said, go. Just go. Go. Because you are already okay. You have been made whole. You know, Father, I want to say this today. The Bible is very easy. Christianity is easy. it is the preachers and the so-called theologians that make it complicated. It is so easy. Hallelujah. Yeah? So easy. Pray for people, receive deliverance. Receive. Easy. Why do we have to go and, you know, get the special prophet to tell you that your name is John? Why do we have to get a special prophet to tell you that if you, your house, when you walk out of your house yesterday, something was wrong? Why? Just tell the people the word of God. And the Bible says signs and wonders we follow. Just say only the word of God. Why do we complicate issues? Why do we have 50 books about the Holy Ghost? When all you got to realize is the Holy Ghost is here to deliver you to satisfy. Yes. Hallelujah. That is why I go to the Bible. I see what the word of God says. I don't get twisted up and down. This is my word. This is my prophecy. This is my everything. No, I'm not listening to your prophecy. I'm listening to the word of God. I am tired of all these so-called prophets. Bring oil, buy this, buy that. No, let's go back to the word of God. Jesus said, go your way, you are made whole. I know people don't like when I say this, but I tell you, I have to be honest with you. Hallelujah. We're going to come back to what God was saying. And remember, hallelujah. I remember those days, even when Pastor Reverend Warbuck, I remember when we were alive for someone's prayer time. It was powerful time. We would empty our stomach, come to church, we lay down, we cry to God, we'd be praying. You come and see church on Sunday, it was different, it was something else. You see people crying out to God, you see healing and deliverance. We are praying, somebody there is being delivered without anybody touching him. Today, we have to call a special anointed person to make deliverance. Why? You can make hallelujah. You know, you are because hallelujah. You can pray for the sick. You don't need to travel to Belgium for someone to pray for your cancer. No, you do it. You have the anointing. You have the power. You have the hallelujah. You have the and you can do. Because Jesus said, I am with you. Because Jesus said, arise. When this man saw that, the Bible said, and immediately, somebody said immediately. He received his sight. And followed Jesus all the way. That's all. That's why I love the Bible. I tell people, read the Bible. You know why? Because the Bible wasn't written by anybody else, but by the Lord. So it's a guideline for you and I. Let's get back to that scripture. Let's hold on to the word of God. Let's remember that what happened to this man can happen again to you. What happened, hallelujah. Hallelujah. The word of God, today is your day. God is calling us to a higher experience, yes. A higher truth. Let us stop playing round the circle like a teddy bear. We tend to play round the circle. Let's come out of the circle. Hallelujah. Let's come out of the circle. Let's come out of that stupid circle and begin to walk in faith and in power and in victory. Let's declare that we are more than able. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's remember that God called us for a time like this. Hallelujah. You know, people of God, I get really frustrated sometimes when I see these mega churches and all these big names. And then we see that the word of God is forsaken. People making big money from preaching. And you wonder to yourself, what about the dying souls in the villages? In the town that nobody cares about? Everybody wants to go to the city. Why can't people just remember what Jesus did? How many people will live like Jesus today? Why are we complicating? Friends, Jesus says, go your way, you are okay. That's all. Pastors and ministers in the house, I want to encourage you. Preach the word of God. Don't add any salt and pepper. It doesn't make any sense, yeah? Because you know what? I remember one day, my mom cooked bitterly, and it was very bitter. Bitterly is very bitter. So I wanted to do something one day. I said, this, I can't eat this bitter leaf. I don't like it. You know, so I'm going to put some sugar. So I brought sugar and I put a lot of sugar in the bitter leaf. Oh, it was terrible. I had to throw it away. You know, I had to throw it away. The way bitter leaf is made is bitter leaf. No matter what you eat bitter leaf, you know. So don't change bitter leaf. Hallelujah, amen. Amen. So what I'm saying is that, you know, the word of God is so simple and so powerful. So let us not bring our salt, our pepper, our onions, and add to it to make the food quicker. No. Pastors in the house, declare the word of God as it is. Reverend Wambo, tell the people the word of God. They may not like it, that's the door they can walk out. If you don't want to, that's up to them. Because you will stand before God, and God will ask you, my son, did you speak the word? Say, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. That's all. Yes. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. This morning, as a church, I'm going to ask you. He said, rise, he's calling you. Yes. So why are you keeping you staying there and you are going around and you're not moving forward? It's time to rise up. My son, can you come, please? Hallelujah. I want to pray for this young man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.